Isoko wado. Eh, me do wa is your ure isoko be di nenena. Wareno ma kedi u fikio o be ya nore wo na bisni kuri na barasona. Kana mara kedi una. Ma ula yego mama ware na ure fi ba ko mai. Le ko re ma timu na ula jogwari eno. Ari se se he. Eh na si kuri na barasona. Uzen mi ha be tag bye wa rori e. Ore ve wo na. Obi gba wo. What I kedi u o ti bo wo hotel wo gene. Be wo ba kedi u. Oje benya ugbere ruhu omara vitawo ya no vitawo ma mazizi ubona kime ozo de oyo hobo e problem na wa ugbere ni ugbejo zo ho ari gbere bia ko he e jini na ma wolo wure gba ho isoko o are me wolo ruho be wolo jesu gere no isoko avo ibo aku magbete re ove lo ho ma ugbere no waso isoko isoko wa no ma lo ewure obi kebe avo ibo akale gaga reko afike awu na reji soko ho oyibo mitiro wuro isoko na kire awura reyo ibo ove vera yo isoko na viese no ire reji soko keme bede ro isoko ro wure awu bubu ati wo to die ware na ma bi wure fikire wali lo me kire wuro isoko. You're welcome to today's edition of The Root. The Root is a program that is being packaged and put together by DFM radio station in Manchester, United Kingdom. It's going to be running a series of programs, but because of the free time I have and being at home this period, I felt that you use my small camera, my phone camera, to record something to have you people occupied while we're looking forward to the big picture. We're going to start by looking at Isoko alphabet. First, I want you to know very clearly that Isoko and English are interwoven. They are very much related. For instance, look at the Isoko alphabet. We have 27 alphabets in Isoko, while English has 26 alphabets, difference of one. And Isoko has 80 consonant sounds. The English has 21 consonant sounds. What this means is that Isoko is a phonetic word. That means that your ability to blend, particularly the vowel sounds, helps you very well to be able to connect how to speak Isoko. For instance, everybody can write Isoko. Let me tell you, if I say Omo, which is a child, Omo, everybody will just write O-M-O. It will get you Omo. It's as simple as ABC. If I say Omo, everybody will just use the English part of it, the pronunciation of English, to look at it and you will get the Isoko part of it. The difference is that the O in Isoko that you now put a dot under. But without even the dot, you can be able to understand it very clearly. If I also say Aye, Aye, the word Aye in English is the same Aye in Isoko. But in Isoko, the meaning is woman. What if I ask you to write the word Omote? Omote. Omote. You can see that O. The moment you break the syllables, we are able to get clearly the pronunciation of omote. So going back to the alphabet, in Isoko, you have A, B, D, A, E, Fi, Gi, Hi, I, O, G, Ki, Li, Mi, Ni, O, O, Pe, Re, Se, Te, U, O, Vi, Wi, Yi, Zi. If you look at the Isoko alphabet, particularly the vowel sounds in Isoko alphabets, the way you pronounce the phonetics of English sounds, that same way you pronounce the Isoko phonetics of Isoko alphabet. You know very well that in English, the word A is A, is the same thing in Isoko. Our pronunciation is A, the same thing as A. This word, E, the E, its sound is A, in a pronunciation in English words. Even the O that you have here, it's like an O, like writing O-R, O. So the moment you are able to understand the English phonetics, it is as easy as ABC in understanding Isoko phonetics. Isoko has 9 vowel sounds. The A, A, E, I, O, 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 U, O,
They are the nine vowel sounds. Why the English voices are A, E, I, O, U? A, E, I, O, U. Those are the five vowel sounds in English. Apart from the A sound in the vowel sound, the other eight vowel sounds are a repetition of the four vowel sound that's when you remove the A. What that means is that the moment you are able to master the five vowel sounds in English, you have already known the nine vowel sounds in Isoko. For instance, the moment you are able to write the A, the I, O, U, as in A, E, O, U, the word in English, apart from removing the A, these are the five vowel sounds in English. When you remove the A, the moment you duplicate this, you are...
Mm-hmm.
So as we were saying, if you look at the vowel sounds, the moment you are able to duplicate the vowel sounds, it's easy for you to get it. If you duplicate these four vowel sounds, to add dots in all of them, you put a dot in all of them, you put a dot in all of them, you have gotten the other four vowel sounds that make up the nine vowel sounds. You can see that there is a relationship between English language and Isoko. It is very, very easy. But there is something I want us to understand. Many, there are arguments that Isoko should have kept their own normal vowel sound instead of adding these words that is difficult to pronounce most times, which is the O and the E sound. These sounds are useful because if you don't have the sounds, you will be able to confuse yourself when you are pronouncing specific words, as it were. Let us look, for example, when you want to pronounce the word re, re means it, re. So the re, e, re, e means it. But if you want to say the sentence so that you now use the word re, you can see that the pronunciations, they are different. The words, they are different. Re and re, they are different. If you are not careful, you can miss one for one. So Isoko have now developed their alphabets that can depict what you are speaking exactly, so that the reader or the listener can understand you very clearly. Also, if you want to use the word ewe, some people are arguing over the VB, that the VB word is an Urobo word. That is not part of what we are arguing yet. You can use ewe, which is VB, or ewe, which is W. Any word that you are conversant with, you can use that. Ewe, which is monkey, and ewe, which is eczema. You can see the two pronunciations, ewe and ewe. The two of them, the words are close. But if you are not careful, when somebody say ewe, you will not be thinking that it is eczema. But the moment you are able to use the right word to look at it and write it, you are able to get it right. Let us still go further. If you want to use the word welcome, dede, dede bo, dede, that is welcome. What if you want to say the thing is very thin? Thin. Dede, dede, the a sound. Dede, dede, the a sound. It's different from the a sound. So if you are not careful, you will want to use this a to mean a. The two pronunciations are very much different. So what we are trying to say here is that in Isoko alphabet, it is easy for you to learn Isoko by understanding the English language in clear terms. It is very easy for you to learn Isoko. But today, we are going to close here, and subsequently, I will introduce you deeper into the Isoko language. Thank you for being here. Stay safe, stay in, and enjoy yourself.